Tuesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And on this week's show, first of all, we've got by Alan Rorrison, EVP.
What does it stand for?
I've forgotten.
Electronic voice.
Projection or something like that. I can't remember. We've watched the whole thing by Chris, presented by Chris Overly. It's a download. Doesn't come with a DVD explaining it. We're going to try and demonstrate
it. Bigger. There's no DVD in it.
No DVD in it. It's all download. We're going to demonstrate. Can we borrow your phone? We haven't set this up, but he does know that he's got to put it on voice memo. And we're going to
just have a look at the pictures.
Make a little bit of a voice recording here. And we're going to do this quite fairly. And this is genuinely anybody's borrowed phone.
And it's on voice recording.
Yeah, and we're gonna record the voice. So right here, I'll leave it just there. And we're just going to try and contact any spirits that might be here in Rugby. I'm just going to record this. And it's quite interesting when you make the recording. We're recording now. We just want to check, is anybody there? It's quite weird. I can't hear. Maybe we're in touch with people or something like that. Sometimes the spirits are trying to get in touch with people. Who are you trying to get in touch with today? Nothing? Do you have any message for anybody here? No, I can hear trains and that kind of thing.
But I can hear an aeroplane now.
That's all I can hear. Let me just stop that. And you can give them the phone back now, and we're just going to play back that last recording. Let me just, do we just press done now?
Oh, play.
We can save it. Let's save it as the new recording. That's the one that we've just recorded just there. I'm gonna play this, make sure we're not on silent. Turn it up and hit play. Let's just hear what we hear right now. And it's quite interesting when you make the recording. We're recording now. We just wanna check, is anybody there? Quite weird. I can't.
Did you hear that?
Maybe we're in touch with people or something like that. Sometimes the spirits are trying to get in touch with people. Who are you trying to get in touch with today?
You are holding their phone.
Nothing? No?
Nothing.
Holding their phone.
Do you have any message for anybody here?
That's amazing!
I think you better get in touch with those people and...
You could be owed up to £3,000 back. We did it earlier on, didn't we? We did it earlier on and it asked if you'd had an accident in the last 5 years. It was amazing, didn't it?
How did they know? The spirits are weird. Remember, they're always watching, so they know these things. Look, you wouldn't normally play this for comedy, but...
I would.
Yeah, you would. You only have to see Chris demonstrating this on the DVD to see the reactions that it gets. It does get amazing reactions. I had a trick that was similar to this many, many years ago by Cesaril called Spirit Sounds. And it was a different method, but it was exactly the same effect. But it doesn't work as well with modern and new iPhones now. But the effect has been out before. This method, I've only played around with it today, having bits of fun with it. I've never had a problem. Every time I've gone to do it, tested the gimmick that you get with it, that means that you can make this happen on somebody's phone with no apps or anything. It has worked flawlessly every single time.
You can use it for predictions.
Predictions. You can reveal any sort of information you like. It really is that clean. Nothing set up with the mobile phone. It's very, very strong. Very strong effect. It's not cheap. But the gimmick that you get inside works very, very well. And it only took about 5 minutes to set it up, that little demonstration there. And you can have anything come out on the phone that you want to. I actually quite like it. Whether I'm going to use it or not, I don't know. So I'm a bit funny about, you know, convincing people that that sort of thing might be real. I've just got a little bit of a weirdness.
I'm
going to
do it for that gag.
Yeah.
I am going to do it for that. It's worth it for the gag. It is worth, that's a good, if you're a comedy performer, that's a good gag.
Is it, and do it near the microphone so everybody could hear.
Well, no, even, you could do it walk around.
Close up or something like that. Look, however you're going to use it, if you want to use it, we've added out, we've done an unboxing, we've tried it out, the gimmick works very well. You only need to see the reactions, like I said, on the live performances. This absolutely freaks people out.
I showed the trailer of this to my wife. And she was like, no, I don't want you doing that. That's going to scare me and the children, that. I don't want you doing that.
I can imagine. You've got to be careful with something as powerful as this. We like it. We like the gimmick. I'm giving it 91%.
93.
So next we've got Cody Fisher, our good friend from across the pond. Killer prediction. Actually, Cody got a bit upset with our last review, didn't he?
I couldn't believe this because I thought it was a fair. I thought it was a fair review. I know Cody didn't like it. I can't believe the.
He was honest.
You two on the magic. Go to the magic cafe. You two keyboard warriors. Go to each other like cats.
Well, he said it was personal. He said it sounded personal. Look, it's not personal.
He made it personal.
Yeah, we actually just didn't like the routine. It was quite a standard routine as far as we were concerned, and didn't like the fact that.
Knobcakes.
For a corporate audience, I didn't like the fact that you get people out and use such obvious double entendre. I didn't like that. You're going to have to live with that, Cody. I'm sorry about that. But then we had a look at, we wanted to watch his book test, because a friend of mine told me how good it was.
Yeah.
Now, unfortunately, the DVD has not worked twice. So we're still trying to get a DVD that actually works.
But when we get one that works, we'll watch it.
And we're looking forward to it.
I'm the one that's excited about watching the book test.
We've heard good things about the book test, but we did have a look at Killer Prediction today. If I had to say one word review, first of all, what would you say, Sean?
Say what?
One word review.
One word review, prediction.
No, of it. That's not a review. That's what it is.
So review it in one word.
Yeah, go for it.
Like, amazing?
Yeah, it's awesome.
It's brilliant.
It's really, really good.
The method is so deceptive. The audience are never going to track back. It's a study. Do you want a synopsis on it?
Look, this is really, really a good routine. It starts off, he puts a deck in the audience as a prediction. Now, you're going to think you know what's going on with this deck. But actually, there's so much more to offer. He leaves the deck in the audience as a prediction.
And the subtleties as well.
There's so much that goes into it. He's got three balls of paper, coloured balls. He throws one ball into the audience. He says to that person, think of the value of a playing card. Then he throws another ball into the audience. That person catches it. Colour.
Yeah.
And then it was value, wasn't it?
It was colour. Then it must have been suit. And then it must have been value.
Value.
That would make sense.
And then they've named a card. The person comes out of the audience with the deck of cards. And that card is the only card that's reversed. But then the three people in the audience unfold the piece of paper in the video demonstration. It was filmed live in the comedy club, same club actually as the Three Ropes DVD. They unfold it, and when they unfold it, there's a great visual where the three bits of paper say 10 of hearts. Absolutely incredible. And you know what? That was incredible. His handling of the deck. That's a very, very well-known deck in magic that you sometimes can't see. It's sometimes
that's
invisible.
That's worth the price of the DVD.
His handling is genius. And he has a spectator out, and the spectator is looking from the back at the same time as the audience is looking from the front. And the way he blocks that, I've seen nothing like it. It's absolutely brilliant.
That's for me, if I'd have bought this DVD, that bit would be, we both went, ooh.
That's good.
Brilliant, brilliant. And then you get onto the rest of the method, and the method's really good. The audience are not going to guess how this is done.
It works. It's got a great energy to the routine. Throwing the balls out, I always worry about, but it's very well managed. He's got a nice couple of gags with everybody who he throws things out to, and you get a great visual. This is the sort of magic that we like. Well-routined and very, very strong magic.
What's nice about this is if you're doing that routine, can we say the name of that? That deck, or
well, the people know.
If you are using that deck, the audience, especially if they've seen you earlier on in the night, maybe doing close up magic, they might say.
You said this, yeah.
Yeah, they might say that it's reversed its way around in the pack.
Using sleight of hand.
Yeah. You know, if that guy can keep making that card jump up to the top of the pack, of course he can turn the card round in the pack without us seeing it happen. What this extra bit into the routine does, it proves that you really did predict it before the show even began.
I guarantee, I know it's such a strong word, everybody that uses this deck in stand-up will look at this and go, oh my God, I have to do it this way from now on if they buy this.
It's like Cody says, the audience part, it has a lot more audience participation into the routine. Yeah. It turns it into a routine rather than a trick.
And it makes the trick stronger.
One of
the tricks that is one of the strongest effects in magic.
Makes it even stronger.
Makes it even stronger and then gives it an incredible visual kicker.
Yeah.
Look, we'd heard about Cody before he came over on his lecture tour and we'd heard very good things. We were disappointed by Three Ropes. Our opinion on that does not change, but this is a completely different product. Everybody's entitled to an impartial, non-personal review, and we really like Killer Prediction as a product. We really like this. We're giving it 95% from me.
Yeah, I'm going to give this 94%. I'm going to do this.
At the end of the show today, don't forget to check out the trailer for my new creation, The Vault.
The Vault.
Presented by Wayne Fox. We'll stick the trailer on at the end of this show if you've not seen it already. This is Unbelievalope. It's Unbelievalope. Unbelievalope. By Jeff Kaylor. Now, anybody that's got any card to Spectator's wallet will already be familiar with this utility device because Jeff first tipped it on that product, the any card to Spectator's wallet. Very well-known gimmick now, but I don't want to say too much about it. On that DVD, he had a fantastic open prediction effect that utilizes these envelopes. Now, the thing is, with these envelopes, the window in the front is absolutely huge. Look at the size of that. Absolutely huge. And you can leave a prediction, playing card, anything like that in full view throughout your whole show. And then in the action of just removing this card, very, very cleanly indeed,
it looks so
you can
deceptive.
Achieve the unbelievable. That is why it's unbelievable. It's the Unbelievalope, and it works very well in Jeff's stage show. He uses it in a prediction effect.
It's the best way
he?
To use this would be a prediction, like a dream date type effect.
He uses it as like a confabulation thing. He says that he's going to go on a vacation with his brothers, and he gets people to pick various destinations, how much it's going to cost. And he also utilizes, in his stage routine, the any card to Spectator's wallet gimmick as well.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you put the two together, it means that it can be very, very clean indeed, because your hands can be totally empty. You can show the envelope on both sides. Remember, this has never been out of sight at all. You then go into the envelope, you cleanly take out this prediction, and the prediction matches perfectly. It is a fantastic tool. I know a friend of mine, Mark Shundo, is already out using this in the real world as the finale to his cabaret act. It is really, really that strong. This is one of the best products I've seen in a long time. We've got some good products today already on the Wizard Product Review. I met up with Jeff last year when I went over to Orlando, and he was kind enough to give me a sneak preview of this and give me a couple of these envelopes. All I can say is these things are unbelievable. I use it in my parlor show. I can't give it any higher recommendation, really. It's one of those products that people go, oh, that's just an envelope. It's not that exciting. But it's so clean. If you use it with the other gimmick as well, it's absolutely fantastic.
But an envelope, say, on an obtrusive, you know.
Especially that.
You know, a chest hanging above a stage that comes down to a table that's been wheeled on, blah, blah, blah. This is
an envelope.
That on the mic stand throughout the whole show.
Yeah, just clipped on there.
I mean, that's as organic and real as it gets.
I think you do need to get the Any Card to Spectator's Wallet gimmick as well.
Absolutely.
To get the best out of it. I just want to be honest there that, you know, you might not have every tool that you need to make this absolutely incredible. And you need to do about 5 minutes of presentation. If I had to say one negative, and you know, I think this about EVP as well, even though you've got downloadable instructions, which are brilliant, it's great to see downloadable instructions on the iPad, and some computers don't even have DVD drives these days, and everybody's just got a DVD player in their front room, maybe. I still like to get a DVD as well, because I had to wait quite a few days until I got a decent internet connection, because I was away in the sticks doing a show, before I could watch it. And sometimes I think you have to think about people that don't get a decent internet connection. So it was just downloadable instructions. It looked like there was a DVD in there, and I think there should have been a DVD. As with this one as well, even though the downloadable instructions are good. Doesn't take anything away from Unbelievalope. You weren't as familiar with it. Sean, what did you think?
I thought it was brilliant. It's so strong. If you're doing this as a prediction type effect, it's a show closer.
The only negative is it looks like a normal object. There's not much production value.
Why is that a negative?
I'm just going to say, if you're not a strong performer, because you need to put an engaging performance script around it, you need to work with it. But that, for a good performer, is actually a strong point, because this looks so...
I'd rather be going to an envelope than like going, can you just bring that chest down and bring that table on, and I'm going to climb the ladder here and all that.
How much are you going to give this?
96%. Yeah, that's look, some strong things.
You know, 95%, 100 if it would have had a DVD. If you've got the Any Card Spectator's wallet already, you might have some instruction to actually know how to make these already. But you get the envelopes, the perfect envelopes, which makes it very, very easy to gimmick up in just a short amount of time. These have been specially produced for this effect, Unbelievalope. There's so many extras on the DVD, including how to make the envelopes from scratch if you want to. So many extras. It's a great project. It's from Jeff's working repertoire. There's tips on there from Cody about how to deal with the confabulation. It's a really, really great project. Finally this week, we've got Canic from the legend that is Nicholas Lawrence.
Ooh.
Sorry. Not so popular around here anymore.
Not anymore.
Not after they saw. What was it called? What was it called, that trick?
I've forgotten. The vanishing deck thing.
Yeah, where it pushed it down.
Diminished, or something like that.
I can't remember what it was called. I blocked it from my memory. Can you synopsisize the effect of Canic?
Basically, you pick up a can. Yeah. That's the can bit.
Yeah.
You take the ring pull off. You put the ring, cleanly snapping off, you put the ring pull in the spectator's hand.
In the spectator's hand?
Actually, in the spectator's hand. You turn the can upside down, so the bit where the ring pull would be is now above their hand. You hit their hand lightly, don't hurt them. It's not funny. Then the ring pull is not in their hand anymore. It looks like it's disappeared, almost like a strike vanish in the spectator's hand.
You hear
it tap. You curiously turn the can over. And the ring pull is now back on the can, and they can examine it. This is as strong as a visual magic as it gets.
It looks fantastic. It really, really is good. This is Nicholas back to his best. Canic is a worker for anybody that's happy to deal with props in this situation.
Yep.
Because it needs to be the sort of thing that you make look as organic as possible.
Well, but there is organic ways. You're saying this. There's that preparation way.
Yeah.
There is a method on there where you can...
No, I'm saying in a performance. You've got an empty can.
No, but I'm saying there's that bit in there. If you're a restaurant worker where you could go up and use a can.
Yeah.
Like Coca-Cola or whatever that was actually on the spectator's table. There is that method. There is that method on the DVD.
Talking about method, how reliable is the method, would you say?
100%.
Yeah, it's really, really strong method. So much so that when we watched it, you know straight away, you go, that will work. That's going to work.
It's something that can't not work.
Yeah, it works flawlessly.
In fact,
flawlessly.
We even said the guy on the DVD is making too much secure. The guy on the DVD is doing too much of a certain thing to feel secure himself that the method's going to work. He could actually use less of something, couldn't he?
Yeah.
And it would be a cleaner trick.
Yeah, so it's really nice. Now, there's a couple of different methods. One leaves you a little bit dirty, the can, when you have it checked.
But only a little bit dirty.
It's not the sort of thing that's going to be discovered by the spectator, it's not completely clean. You even said it would be great to get even more gimmicks so you could actually leave them with the can. You would be that confident to leave it with
them. This is the type of thing where it'd be a throwaway thing. In the middle of your set, you go, oh, look, a can, bam. Put it, leave on the table, and then carry on. What I wouldn't want to be doing is going, can I just have that can back now,
It
please?
Reminds me many, many years ago, the way I felt when I first saw Justin Miller's Captured.
Yeah.
Which is one of the best caps in bottles.
Yeah.
But it's like that, but it's a completely different effect. They see you tear off the tab.
And
again,
it's got
your hand
subtlety.
Yeah,
as well.
the fact that your hands are clean beforehand, then you go over to the can.
And
then,
you're holding it by
and
the
you're
ring
dangling
pull
it.
Hand,
yeah. Nice bits that you go, oh, I like that, that's clever. You break it off, they cleanly see you break it off, and the fact that it's on their hand and you just tap, nothing in your hands, you immediately tip it up and they see it attached. You give it to them and they check that it's attached, it's permanently attached. Sign the can if you like, give it away. There is another method which leaves you completely clean, isn't yep. it? Which we actually favoured.
We favoured because you can, like you said, you can go up and go, oh look, just make, whilst you're making a bit of space at the table, and then you're then in that movement, and you're moving a couple of bottles and cans out of the way, you're ready.
You're setting up to do it.
Do a card trick and then go back to the can.
Yeah, you can actually do this totally impromptu yeah. if you wanted to. Like Sean said, just the idea of just picking up a can, oh yeah, I might use that. Putting it back down, you're now set, ready to do it. It doesn't have to be set up like it is on the trailer. The trailer makes it look great. It is great.
It is great.
It's not like the effect last week where you saw the cards go down and then there's a jump cut and then you see them nicely laid out.
This is. I don't know why if you had. Yeah. Anyway. Blah blah blah. But I was going to rant. The can thing works. It's not that difficult either.
No.
You can do this and make it look.
It's only
good.
About 30 minutes. The DVD. It's not Nicholas teaching on this one, but the guys at Sans Mind do a great job showing. It's beautifully shot. Actually, the colours look great, very vibrant, in beautiful close-ups while they're showing you how to set this thing up, and at the end of it, it leaves you in no doubt that you can perform this, you can perform it in the real world, and if that trick suits your performance style, it's a great trick. Is that fair?
It's more than fair, it's incredibly fair.
How much are you going to give it?
It's back again. 99%.
Really, that much? I'm giving it 92 because it's a canon. It's not really the sort of thing I perform with and feel comfortable performing with.
I've got a use for it already. That's why
I've
got a thing that I'm
doing.
You
drink beer on stage.
It's no, I've got a drinks company that I do work for, and I'm like, that's
perfect. See,
I
mean,
for them, they're going to be like, that's like the holy grail of magic.
Absolutely
for them.
Perfect. Look, we've. I think it's been a clean sweep this week. Everything is a great item. It's a fantastic item. We've got so many new items on the site. And don't forget, if you pre-order the vault as well, only at worldmagicshop.com. The vault was kindly presented by my good friend Wayne Fox that road tested it. And Wayne's got an unbelievable deal with us as well because it's a pre-order at the moment. If you pre-order it from worldmagicshop.com, you will actually get Wayne Fox's tab test for free, sent along with your order. But that's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. We'll be back in about 2 weeks' time, as usual, right here live from Rugby. Thanks again to our audience and special guests. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
We'll see you next week or two on the Wizard Product Review.
Is that your signed coin?
Shut the f***.
What?
The Nest of Boxes has always been a classic of magic, but never before has it been so organic. Your keys are left in full view from the start of the routine. Any small object from your spectator vanishes without a trace. Even though your keys have been in full view the whole time, attached to the key ring, there's a box. And inside that box, there's another box. And inside that box, there's another box. But when your spectator opens it, they find inside their signed coin, or indeed their ring. This is the vault.
I'm going to get you to put your initials on there for me. I'm going to wrap this up on a bit of paper as well. Now, I haven't touched my keys the whole time, but they've been there the whole time as well. I don't know if you can see this on there. There's something on there called a vault. Can I just unscrew it for you? Twist.
and inside there's another box. Just unscrew it. Just give it a twist. Just give it a half a turn. Is that your sign point?
Shut the what? How the hell did you do that? How did you get it inside the box? That's what I don't understand. You didn't even touch it.